Hi, hello. Welcome back to another session of special effects for game and entertainment. And today we are going to work in a couple of tutorials about this concept of how transfer one animation from a library of animations to another character, or from, how to manage all different animations within Unreal. So, first of all, we can have a look at the PowerPoint. It might be always a good idea. We are going to work with Mixamo, but don't worry so much. We'll go to that later. Okay. So, kind of more important is to understand how the different elements related to animation are interacting within the Unreal environment. And one thing it's very important is to be able to differentiate between the skeleton, the mesh, the animation, and physics. If you see on this diagram, everything is part of the blueprint. Blueprint are these blue ones, okay? And then the different colors are indicating the kind of data structure that we have. The skeleton is going to be just a hierarchy. Different bones, different connections that are obviously part of a skeleton, and then the mesh is going to be this wire of this mesh of this character you have designed, okay, previously, and many different meshes can share the same skeleton. That's also something that is very obvious. Animation is going to be just, if you think about that, a list of these different skeleton assets during time. So the position of these skeleton assets change. Therefore, the animation change. That is what basically we have when we do motion capture. It's just a collection, a list of these points, these bones, and these vectors in time. And then we need a physics system. When we do things more complicated, like fur or clothes or hair or any other system of particles that is associated to that character, so we will need physics as well. But we are not going to work with that today. So far today we are going to do these two different exercises. The first one would be when seeing how animations are managed when two characters have the same mesh and the same skeleton. Then later we'll do this other case where two characters have different mesh and a skeleton, okay, different skeleton as well. At this point, you should have already worked probably more than here in my case. With this fake scenario, with this furniture, low poly, and these characters, okay, the ones that we called the other day, Darren and Jason, and you should have been already customizing these different elements in the scenario: lights, colors, textures, and to make this a little more realistic if possible, incorporating other assets from other projects or whatever. So, these characters are ready already to perform different animations. If you remember, with the other day we talk about some of the animations when you select the character. You have here this panel, this animation panel, and you have the one that is selected by default associated to that blueprint, and then we have this option which is animation assets, which would include all the ones that we have already imported. Okay. If you need to import more animations, one way to do it is through the Epic engine here to this animation starter pack, and you just select download. It says open on Epic. Okay, and then later you have to say add to project. And you select the project we are working, which is this one. Okay, so well, I already imported that before. So you successfully imported the animations. It should be quite straightforward to change that. As I say, you just select this animation asset, and then later here in Browse, you should have the collection of the different animations that we have imported. So you just select one. There is no one that is related to this particular thing of being sit down. So I'm going to just select that. Okay, and I'm going to also select another death, and I see that you cannot find the death here. And why is that? Well, it is very easy to explain. It's because animations by default are associated to a blueprint. Okay, so in this particular case, the blueprint is this one. So now, instead of a mess, what you would is probably use the blueprint, okay? Because the blueprint will include everything, okay, in this encapsulated in the blueprint. So that way, instead of using this, I will use this one. Nobody will not the difference, okay? So if you go to animations, if I manage to find that. Animations blueprint or use animation asset. Okay, so animation assets, I can select, for example, death 2. There it is. Cannot find that. Okay, so death 3, for example. So that way I'm playing two different animations death. Okay, although they look very similar. Okay.